and go. All right, guys, this is Coach David Delnell with my hopefully 90 seconds of beef for the burpee and corrections for the movement. Coach Courtney behind the camera, thanks, Court, for all your help. Now, here's what I usually see in a burpee, guys. It's very sloppy, very wormy to the top. Here's what it looks like. When they go down to the bottom, they hit the bottom, and then they worm themselves up to the top, putting all that great pressure in the lower back. We've got to execute that and not do it anymore. Not execute as in do it right, but execute it as in kill it. No more worming on your burpee, guys. When you go to the bottom of a burpee, tight midline, just like a push-up, get to the floor, push yourself back up. And when you come back up to the top, here's another thing I wanna see. Feet inside of the hands, preparing yourself in that athletic position for a big jump and a big clap. Do not be lazy when it comes to the jump and the clap on a burpee. Stay tight on the way down, stay tight on the way up. Big jump, big clap overhead. Too many times people get really lazy and I see this or this. Jump. Don't be afraid to be athletic and jump. Coaches, don't let your athletes get away with this nonsense. Make sure they're doing the movement correctly. We're not trying to overdo the burpee and make it harder than it really is. It's a very simple movement, but make sure they're maintaining standards, and as an athlete, make sure you maintain the standards at all times. So when you're doing your burpees, guys, do them right. Get the most bang for your buck. This is the Coach's Beef for this week, and if you guys have any other questions or comments, hit us up, info@otlfitness.com or otlfitness.com. We're more than happy to answer all of your questions, or if there are any movements you want us to go over, let us know, comment, and throw those in there. We'll cover those as well. Until then, we'll see you guys next time. Coach David, Coach Courtney, we're out. Later.